Welcome, everybody. In this particular video, lecture, whatever you want to call it, okay, we're going to compare, as it says there, the OSI to the TCP/IP. And this is exactly what you need to know, all right? Like I said, if you saw the OSI model video that I put up, all right, this particular video is going to compare that to that and a little bit more, all right? So let's begin. You can see the comparison there. The OSI model is 7 layers. We know this. But the TCP/IP model is only 4 layers. Maybe 5. All right? Yes. Because that is a collapse architecture as well. Well, that's the Cisco data model. Sorry. But there's 5 layers also. They decided they wanted to make it into 5 layers. But we'll talk about that in a bit. So when you look at it, we have application, transport, network / internet, because they changed names, and data link and physical. So we got application, transport, network, and physical. 4 layers in the TCP/IP model. What does that mean? If you're being tested or you're using it for troubleshooting purposes or you're looking at it, trying to make sense, because that's the whole thing with these logical models, is to make sense of what's going on in our network. It's a logical model. It's a blueprint for us to follow, for us to troubleshoot. That is it. They state that the TCP/IP model is more streamlined because there's only 4 layers. If you look at the application layer, it maps directly to the 3 upper layers of the OSI, the application, presentation, and session. That's how it maps over, okay? If you look at the transport, it directly maps to the transport layer of the OSI. If you look at the network, it maps over to the network. If you look at the data link and physical, it maps over to the data link and physical as well. All right, of the OSI model. So whatever happens in the application layer of the TCP/IP model is the same thing that's going on in the OSI model in 7 different, layer 7, layer 6, and layer 5. That's it. It's the same thing, okay, that's happening there. So that's what you would look at. That's the model you're using, okay? And in the transport layer, and the transport layer can also be called host to host, okay, because things that happen there, you know, with the TCP, the UDP, the windowing, all these different things, it's just going on there. Network / internet, think about it, routing protocols, IP addressing, all right? So again, it's used to troubleshoot, More streamlined because there's less layers to look at. But if, again, you're taking a test, what they want to know, same kind of questions, if LAS is doing a telnet session to a destination network, what layer of the TCP/IP model is he using? The application layer. If LAS has a negative acknowledgement or the windowing is changing, what layer of the TCP/IP model? Transport. The RIP routing protocol, which works on which layer of the TCP/IP model? Network or internet. Cat5e goes at 100 megabits per second. What layer of the TCP/IP model? The physical, all right? Switches, physical, all right? Because those two, the data link and physical, are part of that particular layer of the TCP/IP model, okay? So OSI 7 layers, TCP model 4 layers. That's what you need to know to pass these tests, okay? Now, you see behind me, you have the OSI, the 4-layer model, and the 5-layer model. Ooh, but look at the mapping. It goes transport, right? The applications, the same, 5 through 7, okay? Transport, layer 4, network, internet, or network, and then network again. I don't know, they just wanna switch it up. They gotta do something, right? Keep themselves busy. But the mapping is still the same. Data link physical to the 4-layer model is called link. Okay, so the 5-layer model is data link and physical, but it maps over the same. That's all it did. It drew a line between data link and physical. So they actually put layer 2 and layer 1 in the TCP/IP model for 5 layers, data link and physical, but it maps directly to both of them. So whatever happens is on that layer. That's your 5-layer model. All right, is the test going to go into that detail? I doubt it that they're going to go, but know it because it is in the book and, you know, you got to take a test or what have you. But in the real world, you care when you're testing cabling, Is it a layer one issue? Is it a layer two issue? Is it a layer three issue? These are the things that you want to look at, all right? Where does it fit? Whatever model you want to use. Now, apparently, because I did do my research, that engineers of today feel more comfortable with the TCP model and they can understand it. I'm like, really? I'm like, why is that? Because they haven't heard of the OSI. I have no, I swear to you, I Googled it and I found it because I want to see if I can get some more info. It's the same thing all over. Everywhere you go, it's the same thing. You Google it and find out. All right? Because engineers of today haven't heard of the OSI? Really? It's in every friggin' book out there. Okay? So I don't see how that is. This slide right here shows it. January 1st, 1983. The TCP/IP model is from ARPANET. 1983 was the TCP/IP. 1984 was the OSI, because the ISO was the ones that actually brought it out, okay? So the newer one is the OSI, not the TCP/IP model, all right? But again, no, both, two separate entities, okay? Two different models. Do you need to know them? Yes. Do you need to know down to the nitty gritty like you would take with some of these courses in college and the universities, and they get down into all these no. Like I said in the video with the OSI model, just know what each thing should work. And again, you're mapping over the OSI to the TCP/IP model. It doesn't matter. It's the same thing. Just map them over. Know the mapping. Know the mapping to the TCP/IP model from the OSI and vice versa. That's it. That's all there is to it. Because in the real world, all you're going to use that for is, hey, what works on this layer? Hey, this is a layer three switch. Oh, it has routing capabilities. Oh, that's in layer three. That's all. It is no big deal, okay? Well, that's it. That's all there's to that. So you saw the mapping. That was our last slide, the mapping, okay? It's no big deal. It's just mapping over from the OSI to the TCP, whether it's a four layer or the five layer. It's easy. It's easy for testing purposes. You know, if you get asked one or two questions on it, that's about it. And again, in the real world, you're gonna, it's a matter of knowing, okay, what device works on what layer, so we know their capabilities. That is all. Cool? I hope you enjoyed it. Remember, if you enjoyed the video, like it and subscribe. All right? That way you get all the upcoming stuff that I'm doing. And believe me, Laz is back. I'll see you in the next.